Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Sunday Omni. If you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing and be sure to like this video as well. Also, don't forget to turn on the notification bell. This way you'll be notified every single time I upload a new video on my channel. So in this video, we are going to be talking about the former Real Housewives of Atlanta star Portia Williams and the mess that we are seeing unfold on her spinoff called Portia's Family Matters. In yesterday's video, I talked to you guys about my concerns regarding Portia's behavior, where she attacked her daughter's grandma and father on her show, and she's actually looking the worst on her own spinoff, and she's doing this to herself. Like, this is her own spinoff, you guys. There's nobody else that's actually doing this to her but her. Okay, she is involved in the production, she's involved with, you know, the storyline and all this kind of stuff. This is her own story. The name is Portia's Family Matters. It's about her, and she's making herself look horrible. Okay, so anyway, I just wanted to talk about the double standard here, and this has to do with the Real Housewives of Atlanta and, you know, Bravo TV. So according to what I heard last year, is the reason why Portia Williams' fiance's ex-wife, Fallon Pina, was not asked to return back to the Real Housewives of Atlanta was because of her fight that she had with LaToya Ali. You guys know LaToya. She's a YouTuber. I'm not a fan of hers anymore. I used to like her a lot because, you know, she's Canadian like I am. And, you know, I liked her at the beginning. Then I found her very annoying, very loud, just a liar too, it appeared, and just too much. But anyway, according to Fallon Pina, LaToya Forever called her, you know, a name that's very offensive towards people with an Asian background. And then all of a sudden, and then also was putting down her husband as well, which was Simon, Dirty Simon at the time. And so Fallon took it upon herself to defend her home, and she did not want to be disrespected in her own home. So she attacked this girl, LaToya. And yeah, Bravo had a problem with this whole incident, and they just basically like just outcasted her, like isolated her completely from the franchise, allegedly. And then I also heard again that maybe they were asking her to come back too. But anyway, that's what I heard last year. And but look at how Portia Williams has gotten into fights on the Real Housewives of Atlanta, and then also on her spinoff, fighting, attacking people, and Bravo TV has no issue with this. There's no issue. There's no consequences for Portia. She can get away with doing whatever she wants to do, but everyone else can't do the same thing. There's like a double standard here. And that's what I wanted to focus this video on, really, is why can Portia get away with all of this stuff? You know, and everybody always sees Portia like she's this just young person that's just out of control, still trying to find herself. And she's a 40-year-old woman, where Fallon Pina is just in her early 30s. Like, you know, but the younger lady is, you know, completely just boycotted or whatever, and just punished for defending herself, allegedly. Well, according to what happened. But for me personally, I believe Fallon, because LaToya Forever, the way I've seen her, LaToya Ali, she's not somebody I can't support her. Because she's lied on her, you know, baby daddy, Adam, and all this kind of stuff. She just lies a lot. So it's hard for me to just kind of believe her. I'm believing Fallon on this one. And I don't think that many people will just lie and say that somebody called them something that's very offensive just like that. And the way Fallon reacted, obviously something was said that triggered her to get out of control and, you know, and defend herself, right? But anyway, for Portia Williams, she was the instigator, in my opinion, based on what I saw in her spinoff. But some people are saying that it was Dennis that was wrong. It was Dennis that was actually trying to attack Portia and come after Portia. But she's the one that got physical, you guys. Based on what I saw, it was Portia that was actually putting her hands up and, you know, going after these people and lost her own self-control. But anyway, would love to hear what you guys have to say down below in the comment section. What do you think about Bravo accepting Portia attacking people on television, but then everyone else can't attack anybody? You know what I mean? There's such a double standard. There's favoritism here, you know? And well, it's clear Andy really loves Portia Williams, but Portia's making herself look really bad. It's not tasteful at all. And you know, Portia doesn't realize this, but Dirty Simon is judging her. He is judging her. She does not even realize that this is the way she's unmasking herself. He can see the things that trigger her. He's watching everything that she's doing. He's read her book. He's seeing her behavior. And I think that Dirty Simon is also happy to see Portia attacking Dennis as well, because he doesn't like Dennis and he's jealous of Dennis, in my opinion. And Portia hasn't moved on from Dennis. She's using Dirty Simon to make Dennis jealous. Portia has not moved on. She's still focused on the cheating. And she also has an issue with the fact that, you know, Dennis dealt with her cousin Storm before her. But I believe that she already knew this. Okay, she already knew all of this. And she hasn't moved on. But Bravo really is, lets Portia gets away with everything. It's just ridiculous at this point. Anyway, until our next conversation, be sure to connect with me on Instagram at Sunday Omni. And if you'd like to get to know me more, please check out the video description. And if you'd like to support me, please get your copy of my ebook. It's called More Than Good Enough. I help women see another view. Take care of yourselves. Cheers.